final of our richest dog race, the $100,000 Arnott Harper National Sprint Championship. From the Apple Isle, Tasmania, they reckon they have the winner, a speedy customer who'll fly out of the number two box, Busy Vintage. He's lean, dark and handsome, the fastest, most dashing fella to come out of Tasmania since Errol Flynn was a pup. He qualified for Saturday night's rich final by whipping the best around the sand tracks of Tassie.
Joe Millimeter, Bounding Black and Bobby Breeve at the champion, let loose halfway down the straight and Busy Vintage for the final by three.
Today I caught up with the champ and his trainer Dave Croswell at Les Harper's Kennels at Kingsford. And while he races under the name of Busy Vintage, around the kennel Dave calls him something else.
Collis after one of the great runners in the Olympic Games.
Because we got a John Collis works with us at the National 9 years, and he's not exactly known for his speed.
Well, this fella is, and there was a black fella that was racing at the time, and seeing this dog's black, and he had a bit of a build, so we named him Collis.
He's lucky to be alive, Busy Vintage. When he was a pup, he and the rest of his litter were stricken with the deadly parvovirus. The disease wiped out almost half the greyhound population of Tasmania. But Busy Vintage was tough and lucky enough to survive. And how do you keep a champ's mind on the job 48 hours before a big race? Well, Les has what's called a fox whistle that a mate brought him from America 20 years ago. In the States, hunters use them to attract foxes. Les wraps his in a small sugar bag, gives it a squeak, and Busy Vintage thinks it's dinner time come early.
Gentlemen, runners are coming onto the track for the Arnott Harper's National Sprint Championship. As you are aware, this is the first occasion at the Arnott Harper's National Sprint Championship Grand Final has carried prize money totaling over $100,000. You've seen the video replays and the like of the respective merits of these greyhounds following their state final performances. And on this occasion, it's my privilege to introduce to you the greyhounds individually. Number one, the red in the lineup, is the Western Australian greyhound Blue Echo. Ladies and gentlemen, would you put your hands together, please, for a greyhound that is chasing 15 consecutive victories. Blue Echo is by Boetzel out of Wandering Cloud, is owned by Mr. Tony Forte and Partners, and is trained by Western Australia's leading greyhound trainer, Mr. David Hamer. The greyhound has had 40 starts for 23 wins. and went through to the night's final following its 30.92 victory at Cannington. Blue Echo has been a model of consistency, as you could certainly read from its performances in WA. Here this evening, as I say, chasing 15 on the trot to set a new Australian record. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together, please, for number one, the red, Blue Echo. Number two, the checks, is the Tasmanian hope, Busy Vintage. Busy Vintage is a black dog by Highland Summer out of Tiny Port. Is owned by S. Coleman and is trained by Mr. David Croswell of Tasmania. And Busy Vintage has reaped 22 victories from 38 starts. Busy Vintage has won in all tracks in Tasmania, and certainly he's proved to be a top-line performer through most of his career. Busy Vintage was stricken with a virus early in his career. He overcame that virus and has gone into such great heights as reaching this evening's grand final. Ladies and gentlemen, representing Tasmania, number two, the Czech, Busy Vintage. Number three, the white in the lineup. For the second time, representing the Northern Territory, will you please welcome to the dais, Defiant Lee. Defiant Lee is by Angwilla Ladd out of Germain, is owned by Jay Grace and is trained by Shirley Farrell of Darwin. And Defiant Lee, as I say, reaching this event for the second time, has had 60-odd starts for something like 30 victories. And Defiant Lee has been, well, all-conquering in the Northern Territory. Defiant Lee has a little bit of early speed, rails pretty well, and is rather strong at the finish. And I'm sure that Mrs. Farrell is hoping for a similar run this evening to those from Darwin, when Defiant Lee, as I say, has always proven to be the greyhound to beat. Number three, the white, Defiant Lee. Representing Victoria, ladies and gentlemen, number four, the blue, Eagle Hawk Star. By Tangalower out of Country Coast, is owned by Mr. J. Gilchrist and is trained by John Gilchrist of Victoria. Eagle Hawk Star is really only a youngster, a veteran of only 19 starts, but 12 of those have reaped victory. Eagle Hawk Star has won on all of the big tracks in Victoria, similar to Harold Park, and as a consequence is receiving plenty of strong support here for this evening's big event. Despite being awkwardly drawn in the four, the connections preferred to race Eagle Hawk Star without trialling in the establishment, because Eagle Hawk Star has handled the track, would handle tracks first up in the past with no difficulty. And they're certainly hoping for the same this evening. Number four, the blue, Eagle Hawk Star. Number five, the yellow in the lineup. Representing New South Wales from the Lidcombe stable of Mr. John Mooney is McGillicuddy. And McGillicuddy is a red fawn dog by world acclaim out of Early Up Lady. Is owned by H. Mooney and is trained by John Mooney of Lidcombe. And McGillicuddy has won 19 races from 40 starts. He's known for his early speed. He won the state final here last week from the same box. And, well, whatever leads him is certainly going to know they're running in the first 300 metres of the event. Number five, the yellow, a worthy New South Wales representative, is McGillicuddy. Number six, the brown, from New South Wales, is Julie's Legend, which is by Satan's Legend out of Julie Beans, is owned by E. Flevel, and is trained by Betty Flevel of Catherine Fields, and this evening is handled by a gentleman who's certainly put the polish on many greyhounds, Mr. Sam Flevel. Julie's Legend has won 15 times from 34 starts, has won six races here at Harold Park, and she has never raced in better form, Julie's Legend. She is suitably drawn near the centre of the course or towards the outside, and whatever, again, is showing to the four in the early stages will know that they're matching it with number six, the brown. Julie's Legend, ladies and gentlemen. Number seven, the black in the lineup, is Dingaan Flyer, a fawn dog by Chief Dingaan out of Ragwood Lass, representing South Australia, ladies and gentlemen, is Dingaan Flyer. Is owned by AC Landon and Partners, trained by W. Rosman, has won 29 times from 63 starts. Dingaan Flyer is, not a greyhound that's had a great deal of experience on the larger tracks such as Harold Park, but most certainly has proven his value in South Australia, and he won this particular state final in grand fashion. Number seven, the black, representing South Australia, Dingaan Flyer. Number eight, the pink, from Queensland. The Gabba representative, if we can call her that way, is Lady Modish. Is a white and fawn bitch by None for None out of Modish Girl. Is owned by Mrs. C. Bowes and trained by Neil Bowes of Brisbane. And Lady Modish has raced 30 times for 12 wins, and she has been very consistent at the Gabba. She likes an inside draw, perhaps, and she's going to have to work hard from the 8 box to get victory this evening. But she's a worthy Queensland representative, where she's done many fine things. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to Harold Park, number 8, the Pink Lady Modish. Ladies and gentlemen, they're the finalists, and they're very worthy finalists indeed, because these greyhounds have won so many races between them. Number 1, the red, Blue Echo, the winner of the Cannington Cup, looking for 15 wins on the trot for a new Australian record. 2, the Czechs, Busy Vintage. Busy Vintage is the Devonport track record holder in Tasmania. 3, the white, Defiant Lee, the runner-up in the Darwin Cup, the runner-up in the Mount Isa Cup. 4, the blue, Eagle Hawk Star, the Shepparton record holder. 5, the yellow, McGillicuddy, the Tweedheads Galaxy finalist and the Goulburn Cup winner. 6, the brown, Julie's Legend, with all of her consistency to take her through to tonight's grand final. 7, the black, Defiant Lee. And 7, the black, I should say, Dingaan Flyer, reached the challenge in the Angle Park for South Australia, which proves his worth. And 8, the pink, Lady Modish, the Gabba Cup finalist. They're the field for the grand final. Put your hands together for them, ladies and gentlemen. They're very worthy grand finalists. As we say so many times, and it's a well-worn phrase, but one that is very true, may the contest be a cleanly contested one, and may the best greyhound win. And following the running of the event, will you please join us for the presentation ceremony with Mr. Patrick Musgrave from Arnott Harper's to make the presentation with Mr. Neville Bailey, President of the National Coursing Association. Thank you very much. Now they're about to move into the boxes for the grand final. Yes, they're moving in. Blue Echo defiantly locked away. McGillicuddy, Dingaan Flyer, Julie's Legend, and Lady Modish set with Busy Vintage, Eagle Hawk Star, and the green lighters through to the control tower. The bunny set in motion for race 6, the 84 Arnott Harper's National Sprint Grand Final. They're set. They're ready. And racing, Busy Vintage got away well with Defiant Lee. Lady Modish followed the rails by Blue Echo. Julie's Legend and McGillicuddy trying to force up. Dingaan Flyer's coming down, and McGillicuddy and Julie's Legend were checked, and Busy Vintage got the fly. It's 3 on the Western Australian. Blue Echo 2 lengths away next is Eagle Hawk Star, McGillicuddy, Julie's Legend, Defiant Lee, Lady Modish into the straight, and Busy Vintage in front. Coming after it is Eagle Hawk Star from Blue Echo, but it's Tasmania's to grand final, and Busy Vintage is going to win the money. Busy Vintage scores by 3. Second in the race, Eagle Hawk Star, Blue Echo, followed by McGillicuddy, Lady Modish, Dingaan Flyer. Next home in the race was Julie's Legend with Defiant Lee, one of the last ones home in the grand final of the Arnott Harper's National Sprint Championship for 84. Stand by for the placings. Tasmania takes out the grand final. Number 2, the Czechs, Busy Vintage, in the time of 26.38. 2 Czechs, Busy Vintage is the winner. Second prize goes to 4 the blue, Eagle Hawk Star. And third is 1 the red, Blue Echo, 26.38. Dog by Harlan Summer out of Tiny Port is owned by S. Coleman, trained by David Croswell of Tasmania. 4 blue, Eagle Hawk Star by Tangalore out of Country Coast, trained by John Gilchrist of Victoria is second. 1 the red, Blue Echo, by Bewetzel out of Wandering Crenard is owned by Tony Forte and trained by David Hamer of Western Australia. Gentlemen, let me hear your hands for Tasmania. Number 1, which is Busy Vintage, carrying number 2, the Czechs Rugs. Ladies and gentlemen, Victoria has run second with Eagle Hawk Star, Western Australia third with Blue Echo. ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome to the microphone the president of the National Coursing Association, Mr. Neville Bailey, MBE, to introduce the presentations. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Neville Bailey.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The National Coursing Association have been proud and honoured to be the host club for the grand final of the 1984 Arnott Harper National Sprint Championship. I'd like to take the opportunity on behalf of my committee to thank the Chairman of Directors of the Greyhound Breeders, Owners and Trainers Association, Mr. Bob Payne, AOM, his fellow directors, and their executive staff for the assistance they have given the National Coursing Association because of circumstance we've had to transfer the venue of this grand final of this great sprint championship. I'd also like to thank the President and Committee of the New South Wales Trotting Club for also making the venue available. It's now my pleasure to introduce to you the newly appointed Chairman or President of the Australian Greyhound Racing Association, Mr. Brian Johnson, who is going to introduce to you the General Manager of Arnott Harbour, Mr. Patrick Musgrave. Would you please just give a warm welcome to Mr. Brian Johnson.
Thank you, Neville. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's certainly a pleasure for me to be here this evening and represent the Australian Greyhound Racing Association. The association is a formation, as everyone knows, of major clubs throughout Australia. And the finalist of tonight's race has been selected from finals being run in each state, and the best sprinters in that state are here this evening representing the Commonwealth. Unfortunately, there only can be one winner. Tonight is Tasmania. Congratulations to Tasmania. Because it's the first time, I believe, that a Tasmanian dog has ever won a championship. And that certainly is a tremendous feat. The the Australian Greyhound Racing Association is certainly a formation of hard-working people. And I'd like to thank Neville and his directors for presenting such a fine meeting this evening. And I'd also like to thank Mr. Patrick Musgrave and Arnott Harpers for being such loyal and supportive sponsors. Patrick has already indicated that there is no problems in the 1985 sponsorship last night, but I'd like him to say that himself later on, just to make sure everything's above board. But it is my pleasure, ladies and gentlemen, to introduce Mr. Patrick Musgrave, the General Manager at Arnott Harpers. Will you please join me in welcoming him to the microphone? Mr. Patrick Musgrave, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Brian. What an exciting race it's been tonight, and a first for Tasmania ever to win the Sprint Championship Grand Final. An absolutely fantastic race. I'd like to thank all the member clubs of the Australian Greyhound Racing Association all throughout Australia for the organisation of the heats and the state finals that led to the dogs coming here tonight. My thanks to the directors and staff of the NCA for organising tonight's grand final and the state final last week. Congratulations to all the competitors throughout the heats and finals throughout all the states, without which the series could not have been the success it has been. I'd like to thank TAA too for the contribution they've made to the successful running of this whole series. Thanks to the media for the tremendous support that the race has enjoyed in the build-up throughout the various states and tonight up to the grand final. My congratulations to Brian Johnson for taking over now the chairmanship of the Australian Greyhound Racing Association, and we're looking forward as sponsors to a great working relationship with Brian and Howard Ashton of the Adelaide Greyhound Racing Club in the future. And last but not least, a mention I always give when we're in Sydney, to all the taxi drivers of Sydney who've spent, done a fantastic job, some 4,000 of them, promoting and giving away tickets for the grand final tonight. Thank you to all the taxi drivers. And now it gives me great pleasure to present the checks in reverse order. I'd like to present the third prize for $2,000 to, let's get this one right, to Blue Echo from West Australia. And the owner trainer is Mr. David Hamer. I'd like to present now the second prize, which is $4,500 to Eagle Hawk Star, and the from Victoria, and the owner trainer is Mr. Ron Gilchrist. And now I'd like to present the first prize to the owner, Mr. Stephen Coleman, of Busy Vintage from Tasmania. The first prize is for $27,500. There's your check. And the trophy.
Thank you very much, Mr. Musgrove. To the President and Committee of the NCA, thanks very much for staging the race. To Arnott Harper for the very generous sponsorship. I feel very honoured to be associated with a dog. My thanks go to David Croswell, the trainer, to Margaret for the chance to let me race this dog. I feel very happy too that it's a first for Tasmania. They've been at the Cinderella State for some time. And I feel now that they've proved with recent performances that their greyhounds are the equal to those on the mainland. I'll probably forget some other people along the line too. To Les Harper for his great assistance in helping with the dog while he's been in Sydney. And I'm afraid that's about all. Thanks very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to ask Mrs. Patrick Musgrave, or Mrs. Anne Musgrave, if she would now decorate Busy's Vintage with the winning rug. And whilst that's taking place, I'd like to also add the congratulations of the Committee of the National Coursing Association to our friends from Tasmania for the excellent win of Busy Vintage.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, a round of applause for Busy Vintage with his rug so predominant there right now. Ladies and gentlemen, as the photographs are being taken now, that concludes the presentation ceremony for this year's Arnott Harper's National Sprint Championship Grand Final. And our congratulations to all competitors on a fine race. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for braving these conditions at the presentation ceremony. Thank you.